Hi everyone, this is Lanner Smith from Since Memory, and I'm back from a little summer hiatus. And today I wanted to review a fragrance that is as beautiful as that piece of music you just heard, the Maldow. And I chose something that I bought in San Francisco while I was there, and that is by Penhaligon's, the beautiful Blenheim Bouquet from 1902. Now this fragrance has quite a history, quite a story behind it, and I'll tell it to you. Blenheim Bouquet was created in 1902 by the House of Penhaligon's for the Duke of Marlborough. Now, the Duke of Marlborough had a stately family home that was created in the 16th century called Blenheim Palace. Now, Blenheim Palace is one of the most beautiful country homes in England, and it's made of quite a few appearances in film and television. It was most recently, it was Blofeld's Roman, stood in for Blofeld's Roman villa in the film Spectre. And so it played a part of being in Rome instead of in England. So it's made quite an impression film-wise. Now back to the Duke of Marlborough. The Duke of Marlborough, Charles the Ninth Duke of Marlborough, was from this family that had this great estate and great wealth, which had dissipated to practically nothing by the end of the 19th century. And he, in those days, you wouldn't work. You didn't work. You didn't go out and get a job if you were a duke or a duchess or anyone of that ilk in British society. So what to do to save his family, his home, but to marry an American heiress. And he married Consuelo Vanderbilt. Now, their marriage was not very successful. They had two children, and Consuelo wrote a book in 1906 that was considered quite scandalous because she talked about her marriage and her unhappiness. But she was basically sold for a title to the Duke of Marlborough to save his home, and she was... the price was $2,500,000, which is about $64 million today. The Duke divorced her in 1921. The two children she referred to as the heir and the spare, so that's where that phrase comes from. And he then married his second wife, and that was Gladys Deacon. She was also an American. And that marriage did not turn out well either. As a matter of fact, she kept a revolver under her pillow in her bedroom to keep him from coming into her room. So about the only good thing that happened for him was he saved the palace and he had this incredible fragrance created for him. It is a citrus aromatic. And the thing about this fragrance is it has no heart notes. It has top notes and base notes. And the top notes are lemon, lime, and lavender. It's an Amalfi lemon kind of thing. And the base notes are pine, musk, and black pepper. So I'm going to spray a little. By the way, look at this bottle. It is so beautiful. All of Penhaligon's bottles look like this. And they come in this wonderful little like bow tie. And this is a masculine fragrance, but it certainly can be worn by women. And here is, the top comes off like that. And let's spray it first on paper and get our impression of it here. Let it breathe a little bit. Ah, those lemons. This is a great fragrance for spring, summer, and fall. And of course, I always like to say about spring, summer, and fall fragrances that they're great in the winter if you want to revisit sunnier days. The thing about this fragrance is that I'm not a big fan of lavenders, but the lavender in this fragrance is very subtle. Now, when I put it on my skin, something wonderful happens that doesn't happen on the paper. And what that is that the black pepper with the lemons kind of creates this smoky vibe, a kind of smoky, aromatic kind of feeling that is really, reminds me kind of the way a barbecue smells, not when there's food being cooked on it, but just that kind of like a mesquite burning. So you get this kind of smoky, woody feeling in there that I don't know where it comes from. I've never heard anyone else talk about it. Maybe it's just my chemistry, but it's there. It is quite beautiful. It the thing about this fragrance is that it projects pretty well, and the longevity, as I would say, a medium. And of course, you can reapply it anytime. You could just take it in your bag, in if you're a woman, in your purse, and just reapply it throughout the day. It really is beautiful. It has a kind of it has a kind of dryness that is, I would say, kind of like a dry martini. It's sophisticated. It talks of formal evenings, of dressing for dinner, of bow ties and stiff white shirts. But it could also be quite fun out playing tennis or golfing. It just speaks of another era, but in a very modern way. A time of gin and tonics and great trips on the Orient Express. It is a beautiful, beautiful fragrance. I just love it. And I also have the bath oil that goes with it. Let me show that. And here it is. Look at this incredible bottle. It is just beautiful. And this bath oil, you can either put it in your bath or you can use it on your skin after the bath. Just go like this. And it helps elongate the fragrance. It keeps that fragrance. It gives it more longevity. And it's beautifully matched so that it just gives some oomph to this wonderful fragrance. So, also, by the way, Sir Winston Churchill, who also had an American mother, Jenny Churchill, funny about that whole period in British history where America came back in and kind of revitalized the aristocracy. We've had a long and wonderful history with Britain and Britain with us. So anyway, back to this. Sir Winston Churchill loved this fragrance, and it was something he wore often. So there you have my take on this beautiful classic from Penhaligon's, the gorgeous Blenheim Bouquet. This is Lanier Smith from Sense Memory saying, remember, wear what you love and not what they say you should like. Cheers. And one other interesting thing about Consuelo Vanderbilt and the ninth Duke of Marlborough is that the American authoress, Edith Wharton, wrote a wonderful book. It was her last book she wrote. It was published after her death, and it's called The Buccaneers. And it's very loosely based on Consuelo's life and her and the other young women of that period, from the immensely rich American millionaires who sent their daughters off to Europe to attain titles and breathe new life into the aristocracy there.